Connor, are you okay? Listen, if you're hurt, I'll take you to the hospital after we find our friends. But I don't think you can hear me, because I think you might be still knocked out or something.
Huh? What?
Oh, you're awake. You feeling all right after you hit that billboard pretty hard?
Well, not really. My back hurts from hitting the billboard last night. And I hope Dusty and Arlette are okay since they crashed into the woods.
Yeah, I'll be okay too. And we should probably find Gecko, Luke, Duncan, and Millie first, since they're possibly nearby, and they're not in the woods.
Yeah, good idea. Let's look for them first.
So Brave Five and Connor set it off to look for Greg, Luke, Duncan, and Millie. And Brie, if I was right, they weren't far away after all. Oh dear, this is reminding me of the time I ended up in the water after getting chased by the scary elephant. Well, Greg was also getting chased by the scary elephant, remember? Yeah, I remember.
Don't remind us, Luke.
I'm sorry. It's just a little bit funny. Before Greg could say anything, Brady 5 and Connor arrived. Brady 5, Connor, who are we glad to see you? So, did you two, Dusty and Owlette, stop those villains last night and get that Joby Whip back? Well, we, didn't defeat the villains last night. What? You didn't defeat the villains last night and get that Joby Whip back?
Yeah, we tried, but they made us crash. And I don't know how me and Champ crashed.
Yeah, we're gonna have to figure that later. All we know is that Dusty got hit with some, like, camera. Just like in Tokyo a couple of years ago. Yeah, you're right, Luke. Did Ally get hit by Dusty? Yeah, she did, Millie. Ouch.
And I think this could be like Duncan's Friday the 13th story from earlier this year.
Yeah, when those two boys were lost in the woods, the killer chased them, and they sunk into quicksand.
Well, I don't know if there's any quicksand spots in that woods. Literally, I'm barely in the woods. So Brady 5 and his friends know that Dusty and Alec are in the woods, but they didn't know where they were. My pontoon came off, and my wing is all cracked and broken.
And my head hurts from hitting the trees.
Well, you must hit those trees pretty hard, Amaya, and it made you lose your powers. And I'm pretty sure Catboy and Gecko had lost their powers too. Alright, you got new tires, Brave 5. Now I gotta fix your friend. Well, I didn't realize I have flat tires after the crash last night. Yeah, I didn't realize that either. And now I gotta get my rear repaired, since it's all clenched in. And Millie's at the works because she's got a leaky boiler. Well, you're lucky that you and Duncan are not at the works. Yeah, right. And can you go to the works, Brave 5, real quick to see when Millie's going to be out of the works? Yeah, sure. I don't really have anything to do today. So, yeah, I guess I'll see when she's going to be out of the works. Although, I do have my investigation shift tonight, and I plan on finding Dusty and Ally tonight. Oh, right. So, Victor, me and Luke were wondering, When is Millie going to be out of the works?
Well, my friend, we expect she'll be out of the works first thing in the morning.
Oh, okay. First thing in the morning. And Brave 5, how you figured out who's going to be doing your night shift tonight of, looking out to see if one of the villains is up to something? No, not yet, Millie. Oh, okay. And I really hope you'll be able to find Dusty and Alet tonight.
Yeah, I really hope I do.
And when is this train model gonna be out of the works?
Well, we're basically waiting on a shipment of wheels and buffers to arrive, but I don't know when they're going to arrive, Brave 5, my friend.
Well, I see a few wheels on that train model, and that train model kind of looks like the Emerald Knight. And Fang Prison says that the Emerald Knight would be a great engine working on the railway.
Yep, definitely. And the wheels on this train are able to move. You want to see them move?
Yeah, sure. I'd like to see them move.
So wheel turn by wheel turn, the wheel started to turn on the train model that looks like the Emerald Knight.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, pretty cool indeed, Brave 5.
And we also added lights to the train.
I see that. Wow. So, when is this model going to be out of the works? Or should I say, when should the parts come in?
Well, there's a little delay going on, so we don't know when they're going to come in. Oh, okay. A delay.
So do you think I'll catch some fish in this lake, Dusty?
Yeah, I'm sure you will, Amaya. Or maybe something else. I know all about lakes.
Do you really?
No.
Okay then.
So Amaya put her fishing rod hook into the lake, and she tried to catch some fish, but she knew it would take a while for her to get some.
I don't know, Dusty. It could take me a while to get a fish, or something else.
I suppose you're right. Well, we could be here all day, I expect.
But I do hope help comes soon.
Well, Brave 5's gonna be doing his lookout night shift tonight to see if one of the villains is up to something. And I think he might be looking for us tonight. So he might be asking one of his friends if he's going to do it for him. And I see that my pontoon is right over there. And we're going to have to tell whoever finds us that my pontoon, my other one, is over there. So Connor, how you figured out what made us crash last night?
I did, champ. There's some ice on the road.
Ice on the road? No wonder we didn't notice.
And it reminds me of what Romeo had done a few years ago.
I see. And who is he?
As Connor was telling Brave 5 about Romeo, they didn't see an Audi crash into a Porsche.
Oh, that Audi just crashed into that Porsche because of the ice.
I think we should get out of here, Connor, before they see us see them fight. See you later.
As Brave 5 was looking around, asking one of his friends if he would do his investigation shift tonight, he saw Duncan, who was in a siding.
Hello, Duncan. What are you doing here in a siding?
Well, I'm just thinking about Alfie Andrea and that wall.
What's so important about that wall?
I'll show you. I'll get you, Alfie Andrea. Oh, ow!
Wow. I thought you were gonna go on your side.
Well, that depends on how hard I try, my friend. And sometimes, after I hit the wall, I get damaged and have to go to the works. And sometimes, I don't get damaged. And I didn't get damaged.
Okay, I see. And are you available to do my lookout night shift tonight while I look for Dusty and Alec?
Sorry, Brave Five. I can't. I have to work at the quarry all night tonight.
Oh. Okay.
No one was available to do his lookout night shift.
As it was starting to get dark, Brave Five still couldn't figure out who would do his lookout night shift. He already asked Thomas, but he wasn't available. He was working on his branch line with Annie and Clarabelle late tonight.
I just don't understand. Why is everyone so busy this evening? Like, I don't get it.
Well, maybe everyone's feeling so tired after this long day.
Yeah, I suppose you're right, Max. Well, I guess I'm gonna look for Dusty and Alan now.
As Brave Five was heading to the woods, he saw Jackson Storm.
Don't worry, Brave Five. I'll do your lookout shift while you're looking for Dusty and Owlette.
Thanks, Storm.
And now, if you'll excuse me, I must be ready for when someone calls for help. Wait. I didn't say it in my costume, did I?
No, you didn't.
Be right back. There. That better?
Yeah, that's much better.
Alright, now I must be ready for when someone calls for help.
Good luck, what's your superhero name?
Say that again.
What is your superhero name?
Ugh, I still didn't figure it out. But I'll figure it out soon.
Okay, then.
So now, Brave Five was on his way to the woods.
So, you'll be out of the works first thing in the morning. Right, Millie?
Yeah, that's what Victor said. And you got your late night passenger run tonight?
Yeah, I do.
Well, my friend, you probably should start your passenger run now. You don't want to be late, do you?
Yeah, of course.
It was dark when Luke arrived at the station. Philip was there, dropping off the passengers.
Hey, Luke. Glad to see you this evening.
Yeah, I'm glad to see you too.
So, I basically drop off the passengers here, and then Thomas shall be picking them up after the tour around the line.
Yeah, right.
As Luke was getting covered up to his coaches,
he saw his friend Connor, and he didn't expect to see him.
Hey Connor, what are you doing here? It's late.
Well, Luke, I can't sleep. So can I ride in one of the coaches?
Of course you can. Hop on in.
So Connor got on and he's passing around.
The journey went on well, and Connor fell asleep right away in the first passenger coach.
And some of the passengers in Luke's carriage were asleep too. But some of the passengers were awake. Luke pulled his train along the narrow gauge line.
Really hard. hard to get passengers to the stations on time. Soon, Brady finally arrived at the window.
I'm coming, Ella and Dusty.
But he didn't know that they were about to go to sleep.
Come on, I gotta find them.
Well, we're just gonna have to go to sleep and wait for someone to come rescue us.
Well, it's a good thing I can sleep on this for the night. Anyways, good night, Dusty.
Good night, Anaya. So Dusty and Anaya went to sleep. But Brave Five was determined not to give up. He splashed over mud puddles as he was racing around the woods.
Dusty, Alan.
Then he noticed something.
That's Dusty's pontoon. They have to be around here somewhere.
And sure enough, he found them. But then there was trouble.
Guys, wake up, it's me. What was that?
Brave Five. I see that you found my other pontoon.
And are we glad to see you?
Come on, you two. Let's get you out of here. When the sun was starting to rise, Brady Five managed to get Dusty and Amaya out of the woods. Thank you, Brady Five. We thought we were going to be stuck in there forever. But luckily, I'm your friends, and friends rescue each other. Yep, they sure do. Just then, Luke arrived. He had just finished his passenger run, and Connor was still on board. Hey, Luke, I found Dusty and Amaya. Well done, Brave Five. You did amazing last night.
Thanks, and I see that you're going to take Amaya home.
Well, Connor slept in the first carriage last night because he couldn't sleep in his own bed. I see. And I hope I can have Dusty back to his shed before the others wake up. Good luck with that. Thanks, Luke. Alright. I can do this.